Hi everyone, this is Supriya, lecturer in biochemistry. Now I'm going to explain you about free energy, enthalpy and entropy. Okay, let us discuss about these topics. Okay, Gibbs free energy. Here G means G expresses the amount of energy capable of doing work during a reaction at constant temperature and pressure. Okay, here G expresses the amount of energy capable of doing work during a reaction at constant temperature and pressure. When a reaction proceeds with the release of free energy, that is when the system changes so as to possess less free energy. Okay, when a reaction proceeds with the release of free energy, delta G has a negative value and the reaction is said to be exergonic. Okay, when a reaction proceeds with the release of free energy, delta G has a negative value and the reaction is said to be exergonic. In endergonic reactions, the system gains free energy and delta G is positive. Unit of delta G is joules per mole or calories per mole. Okay, next coming to the point enthalpy. Here enthalpy means H. Okay, it represents with H. H is the heat content of the reacting system. Okay, H reflects the number and kinds of chemical bonds in the reactants and products. Okay, here enthalpy reflects number and kinds of chemical bonds in the reactants and products. When a chemical reaction releases heat, it is said to be exothermic. Okay, when a chemical reaction releases heat, it is said to be exothermic. The heat content of the products is less than that of the reactants and delta H has a negative value. Reacting systems that take up heat from their surroundings are endothermic and have positive values of delta H. Okay, when a chemical reaction releases heat, it is said to be exothermic. The heat content of the products is less than that of reactants and delta H has a negative value. Okay, reacting systems that take up heat from their surroundings are endothermic and have positive values of delta H values. Okay, the unit of delta H is joules per mole or calories per mole. Entropy. Next coming to the point entropy. Okay, next coming to the point entropy. It represents with the letter S. Okay, here S is a quantitative expression for the randomness or a disorder in a system. Okay, S is nothing but entropy is a quantitative expression for the randomness or a disorder in a system. Okay, the unit of delta S is joules per mole kelvins. Okay, joules per mole kelvin. Under the constant temperature and pressure, changes in free energy, enthalpy and entropy in biological systems are related to each other by the equation. Okay, under constant temperature and pressure, changes in free energy, enthalpy and entropy in biological systems are related to each other by the equation delta G equals to delta H minus T delta S. Ante free energy equals to Gibbs free energy equals to enthalpy minus temperature into entropy. Okay, here delta G is equals to change in Gibbs free energy of the reacting system. G products, G reactives. Okay, delta H is change in enthalpy of the reacting system, H products minus H reactives. T is equals to absolute temperature, whereas delta S equals to change in the entropy of reacting system, S products minus S reactants. Okay, next coming to the point. Here in living organisms, they preserve their internal order by taking free energy from their surroundings in the form of nutrients or sunlight. Okay, in living organisms, they preserve their internal order by taking free energy from their surroundings in the form of nutrients or sunlight and returning to their surroundings an equal amount of energy as heat and entropy. Example, oxidation of glucose Aerobic organisms extract free energy from glucose obtained from their surroundings by oxidizing the glucose with oxygen. Okay, oxidation of glucose. Aerobic organisms extract free energy from glucose obtained from their surroundings by oxidizing the glucose with oxygen. The end products of this oxidation reaction are CO2 and water molecules, and they are returned to the surroundings. At the end of this process, the surroundings undergo an increase in entropy, whereas the organism itself remains in a steady state and no change occurs in its internal order. Okay, example enti manakam teesukunam deeniki oxidation of glucose. Okay, aerobic organisms extract free energy from glucose which is obtained from their surroundings by oxidizing the glucose with oxygen. Okay, the end products of this oxidation reaction are carbon dioxide and water, and they are returned to the surroundings. Okay, at the end of this process, the surroundings undergo an increase in entropy, whereas the organism itself remains in a steady state and no change occurs in its internal order. Okay, no change occurs in its internal order. Whenever a chemical reaction results in an increase in the number of molecules, okay, whenever a chemical reaction results in an increase in the number of molecules, the entropy of the surrounding increases. Okay, chemical reaction results in an increase in number of molecules, entropy surroundings increases. Okay, whenever a solid substance is converted into liquid or gaseous form, entropy of the surrounding increases. Okay, because these transformations allow the molecule more freedom for movement. Because these transformations allow the molecule more freedom for movement. Okay, this is the overview of free energy, entropy, and enthalpy. Thank you.